What up, y'all? My PokePop here. Welcome back to another video. So today was Nintendo's E3, and boy, was it exciting. They dropped so many titles and so much information today. There's just not enough time to react to all of that stuff. And plus, there's Pokemon Sword and Shield gameplay from Nintendo Treehouse that they did earlier today. So that's what we're going to do in this video. And then tomorrow's video, I will upload one where we do a top 10 title sort of situation because there's so much in that live stream. But let's go ahead and go over this gameplay here, and let's just see what happens. Let's just react to it as it goes, and I'll probably pause here and there, and I'll be cutting out a lot of things, because this is a 31-minute live stream, and I'm not going to put all that in there.
In the wild area, you really find the widest variety of wild Pokemon out of any area in the games, and it also changes the Pokemon you can encounter depending on the weather conditions and where you go and the time of day.
See, we're going to pause there for a second. Just say, like, this is what I was most excited for about this game when I saw it on the Direct. I knew this type of gameplay was coming when this game was announced, before we even got to see gameplay, where it was more like they were taking elements from Breath of the Wild and Super Mario Odyssey. And I think this is the part where that comes in, really. At least for Breath of the Wild, it's like this huge open area. They're calling it the Wild Area. And as we see more of this gameplay, it just gets more impressive. Let's just keep watching.
In the wild area, it spans across multiple towns, so your adventure will take you back to this, the wild area, multiple times. And as you can see on screen here, you can control the camera freely in this area to better find hidden items that are lying about, and also see the Pokemon that are flying above in the sky.
See, that's the key thing there. This wild area connects to multiple towns, so instead of having like one route that directly leads to another town, and another route that leads directly to another town, you're gonna have just like one big wild area that connects to multiple routes, to multiple towns. I think that'll be pretty cool, because I'm thinking that at multiple points in the story, something will change about the wild area, maybe the type of Pokemon you encounter. And I know they're gonna do, you can see there's doing weather effects, kind of bringing back that Gen 4 stuff, or Gen 3. So this is how encounters are going to look like. That's interesting. So it's kind of bringing back the Let's Go Pikachu, Let's Go Eevee element to it. You can see the weather effects in and out of battle. Score Bunny here.
We have the Pokemon wandering about the field. We call them kind of symbol encounters, where you can see the Pokemon before you actually encounter it. But at the same time, you actually just saw an exclamation mark pop up in the tall grass there, and that kind of simplifies that it's a random encounter, so you don't know which Pokemon you're going to encounter. We wanted to have a mixture of both types of encounters in these games to also let players enjoy that excitement of, you know, not knowing what they're going to encounter.
See, I think that's one big criticism that a lot of Pokemon fans had about Pokemon Let's Go Eevee and Let's Go Pikachu, that it was almost just like too easy, and it's taken away from the experience, knowing what you're going to encounter all the time. And that was a big part of Pokemon, especially for me and a lot of people my age growing up, not just going in the tall grass and not knowing what you're going to encounter. So they kind of brought that element back, the random encounter back, which is really nice.
So
we got a Wingull here. Scorbunny looks great, though. It just hops around the whole entire time. That's crazy. So there's a random encounter. This is a random encounter. It's just another Wingull. It seems to me there's a lot of like Wingulls in this one area.
There's definitely a lot of Pokemon to encounter, and of course, as you can see here, the battle system, you know, it's the traditional turn-based battle where you choose moves.
The user interface looks great.
Defeat the wild Pokemon before you can catch it.
It's really clean.
Or battle against it before you catch it.
There's Grookey.
The
graphics look so much better. It looks like there's a lot of Wingull in this area. I think I don't want to interrupt what the guy's saying whenever they're talking in English, but basically what I was trying to say here, it looks like in different areas. I don't think they really said it. I've watched about half of this, but it looks like in different areas, in this wild area, in different parts of the grass, there are different types of Pokemon you encounter, because you see like a cluster of Wingull where they're at right now. But I think in other areas, in other grassy areas, you'll see different clusters of Pokemon, which will be really interesting.
In their one-on-one battles as well.
So that was interesting how they caught that. That's like a traditional way of catching Pokemon in the past games. I thought we were
going to
be using
the
controller again.
You can see it's actually raining right now where we're wandering about.
So there's the weather effects.
Depending on the weather condition, the kind of certain types of Pokemon will appear more frequently. Like right now, we'll see more water-type Pokemon.
And that's why we have so many Wingles.
You'll see more ice-type Pokemon, for example.
So weather affects that Pokemon you encounter. That's really cool.
But it looks like Terry can also whistle to attract Pokemon, and different Pokemon
there's the whistling
have
thing.
Different reactions to when he does that.
My encounter system の話をしてたと思うんですけど、今ちょっと口笛をして、まあいろんなこう反応でポケモンたちがしてると思うんですけど、もうちょっと教えてもらえますでしょうか。
そうですね。
That's the Metapod.
ポケモンは種類によって、まあ近づいて、まあプレイヤーを見ると近づいてきたり、逆にこう逃げて。
I really like the colors on Scorbunny. They really pop.
なかなかこう空を飛んでいるポケモンとかが捕まえづらかったりするんですけど、
Is this what type Scorbunny is?
まあこちらにこう。
I kind of want to see what type it is. I think it's a Alright, so here I found it. Right now, this is the part where they were switching from Scorbunny to, was it Grookey? And right here it says type fire. Now, it does know a fighting type move, which is not unheard of, but I wonder if this type changes as it evolves, which will be interesting, because we don't know what they're going to evolve into yet. They all have Everstones on them. Look at that. South Lake, Mylock, wild area. So it changes. So like, there's a Galvantula over there in the corner. If you guys can see that, that's pretty cool. I wonder if there's any more Galvantula around here.
Yeah,
looks like it's kind of snowing right now.
The wild area. If you wanted to walk really far out there, there's lots of stuff to discover, and it's, you know, it's much.
Okay, so there's a Snover. Sorry, I'm pausing a lot. There's a Snover right there, because now it's snowing, so we're gonna see more. We should be seeing more ice-type Pokemon. That we do.
Wider.
It's really cool seeing like the multi-generational Pokemon encounter field. You know, Pokemon that you can encounter.
And here we have Terry.
Look at that guy charging at you. Like, I'm going to mess you up, bro. Dude, that thing's level 26. He's only level 12. You're going to die, Scorbunny. Oh, so they couldn't run away. Because speed is Machoke's speed is too high.
Scorbunny.
GG, Scorbunny.
The bicycle.
Oh, the bike! Oh, that looks cool! Oh, look at that! There's electricity! Whoa, it
looks
kind of looks like the Acro bike that we had, what generation was that? Oh, look at that! You can ride on water! There's a Vanillite right there. You have these ice-type Pokemon above the water. Dude, look at that. That's totally like something out of Spy Kids. You can go right back on land. You don't need surf anymore. Always looks like there's an item right there, too.
Definitely get you around.
Pungent Root.
And then, of course, we also see that there's
two Pungent Roots.
Secrets out.
There's Gloria.
Different ways to encounter the variety of Pokemon in the area.
Now, one other thing that we've noticed here on the left side is that we're seeing some icons.
I was just asking that question.
So this is part of the new kind of communication functionality we're calling that's through this device called the Y-com in the games. And you can actually have these, what we're calling stamps appear to kind of show what other players are up to.
Oh, it's kind of like that stuff that we used to get in X and Y.
So this is actually Masuda-san playing right next to us. He's playing the Gloria character there. But
he's the one playing the Gloria
signifying that he wants to trade with us.
Trade notification. It shows what they're catching too.
The
players nearby. It's almost like what they had for the Pokemon X. Oh, look! Is that him?
Invite people to battle, trade, or even try and get other players to join you in a max raid battle.
Gloria.
Is it like local multiplayer?
he's playing Gloria right now.
Pack of potatoes.
ワイルドエリアは、いろいろなこう、プレイヤーが違う目的を持って遊んでたりするんですけども、
This has to be random. No, okay, it's random. I still thought it was live for a second.
Right, but there's some lights in the background, these red pillar of lights.
There are lights.
Could you guys explain what is that? These are?
So those are actually what are called Pokemon Dens, and there's a red
Pokemon
light
dens.
Emitting from them when there is a Dynamax Pokemon inside. So it
Dynamax
kind of represents the energy of the Dynamax phenomenon.
Oh, wow.
And what that means for the player is that you can go there and encounter that Dynamax Pokemon in a max raid battle.
Ooh. Well, perhaps we should show what the max raid battle is like.
Yeah! Pokemon Go's coming to the main series Pokemon games, y'all. Here we go. This is stealing.
Whoa.
So they're changing what Pokemon they want to use for the raid battle here? Raid battles, Pokemon Go is coming to the main series Pokemon, guys. Which is not a bad thing. Raid battles are always really fun.
And you only get to choose one, and you can't change during the battle, so you've got to make sure it's a good choice.
That looks amazing.
Strategy and communication is incredibly key.
Cue the Wailord memes. Look at that. That reminds me of that Mega Evolution stuff.
Very important to defeat
gathering the energy. Like a Lon did in Pokemon XYZ series.
Skulled.
Dang, that barely did anything. That was super effective, too.
That'll definitely help protect against some of these powerful attacks.
Walk. Whoa. What?
This is
what it's supposed to look like. What did he just suck into that Pokeball, though?
Dynamax that actually rotates between the players each turn.
Oh, he returned it and then used the energy inside his bracelet
throughout the entire battle. So it's important to kind of identify.
Oh, that is awesome.
To be able to, you know, exploit the.
That is amazing. Look at that.
So yeah, obviously a lot of strategy.
Max Flare. Look at that.
And
it still didn't do that much damage. What? What is this? It's so OP. Sunlight turned harsh.
Yeah, and you can, but with the barrier, what happens is once his HP is reduced, it'll put up this kind of barrier that you have to take down before it will actually start taking lots of damage again.
Nicely done.
Explodes. It's weak now, and then you throw
a single Pokemon faint. That was
you all catch it. How does this work?
Because
in Pokemon Go, you all catch like the same Pokemon.
So now all of us have a chance to actually catch this Steelix.
Oh, there it is.
So by catching it, can we add them to our party?
For the shorties, it's come out a chance to get them. It's come out that
it's like you all can catch it. Look at that. This reminds me of that Pokemon episode where the gigantic Pokemon, they had to use gigantic Pokeballs to catch them. I don't know if you guys remember that episode.
So yeah, you can actually, every player who participates in the battle are able to get a chance to catch it. But even if you don't catch the Pokemon, there's still a variety of rewards for the players that participate to get items and stuff that will help be beneficial in their adventure.
A Grookey pin is life! Yo, I want that pin! I want all those pins! Alright y'all, so the last, like, 5-6 minutes were just them interviewing them about information we kind of already talked about and they talked about in this video as well. But let's review here. So first we got a kind of a preview or showcase into the battle mechanics, raid battle mechanics, the wild area and how that's going to work, what kind of things happen there, weather changes, how that affects how you encounter Pokemon. We got a look into encountering Pokemon. I mean, like, let's just point out the Dynamaxing for a second, because the Dynamaxing, I think, is going to be a big thing. It's something I'm really excited about. It looked kind of weird at first, just because, like, oh, it was like a giant Pokemon, but visually speaking, it looks pretty amazing, and I think it'll, like, definitely change the competitive battle scene, because it's similar to Mega Evolution and Z moves in a way, like, if you combine them together without, you know, the appearance changing too much, because you do get a boost in your stats, and your moves get a boost as well. So that's similar to Z moves, except Z moves can only be used once, and you don't have to dance. And I think the whole mechanics behind it is very, very similar. I think they just took inspiration for Pokemon Go. Since Pokemon Go had a lot of success, and it brought a lot of Pokemon Go players into Let's Go Pikachu, Let's Go Eevee, I think the next step would be to bring those Pokemon Go players into the main series games now. It's just a financially smart decision for them. And since they have that interest in Pokemon now, these Pokemon Go players, and introducing a mechanic they're familiar with. Personally, when I played Pokemon Go a lot, I don't play it so much anymore, but especially when I moved here to Michigan. But when I was playing it, one of my favorite parts of Pokemon Go was the raid battles, because it was such a social thing. I met so many cool people, made a lot of friends that I still talk to today. And it's pretty awesome. I made a lot of lifelong friends just playing Pokemon Go, doing the raid battles thing. And it teaches you teamwork, teaches you some social skills, the socio-emotional development. Is good for the kids, and even good for the adults. As far as the wild area, that's also one of my top favorite things. Probably the most exciting thing for me, actually. Just because you're not stuck on one route anymore. Just one skinny little route to get, you know, to the next place you need to go to. And I like that random encounters are back for sure. Another thing they touched up on in the last 5-6 minutes that I didn't show, but they talked about a new service that'll be replacing Pokemon Bank, essentially. They said after a lot of, you know, thinking and talking about it, they decided to replace it with Pokemon Home, which I did talk about in the Direct last week. And they just said it'd be a better decision for them, which I understand. But the only thing I'm kind of bummed out about is you won't be able to transfer your Pokemon from the past games unless those Pokemon are in the Galar region's Pokédex. But anyway, that's going to do it for me. I'm pretty excited for this game overall. How excited are you for this game? Leave a comment below and let me know. Tomorrow, expect a Nintendo E3 video, kind of a top 10 situation. And I may or may not mention E3 news from other games, or I might just make a separate video about it because there's some other games I'm also really excited about that's not Nintendo related. But that'll be it for now. Hope you enjoyed this video. My Pokepop, signing out.